Hello everyone, I hope you all are fine. So now we are going to start with the second English course book, Vistas, of the first chapter. So let's move on. So first chapter name is The Third Level, written by Jack Feeney. So before we start the chapter, I just want to give you a brief explanation about this chapter, about the theme and story. Third level signifies a type of escape from the modern world that is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry. Okay, like this. The period is about 18 and 90s, represent a peaceful life and not possible, that is not possible in the present era in which we are living. Okay, so from that level, Charlie is the person, Charlie is the protagonist of this story, who is 31 year old named Guy. Then in an evening, while he was going towards home, he decided to take a small way, okay, like a subway, okay, to the Grand Central Station to New York City to go to her, to go to his home. And at that point, he find himself a third level of the Grand Central Station. So this is going to be an interesting story about a scientific invention is there, a psychiatrist type of mental level is there. So let's move on and pay heed on this story. Have you ever had any curious experience which others find hard to believe? Now every time on each and every phase of life, we are going to face many type of experience, and some of the experiences are there you are going to tell anyone, he is going to believe on that, but some of the experience are unbelievable for anyone. Okay, so this story is having something some element about like that is unbelievable for any person. The presidents of the New York Central and the New York, New Haven and Hartford railroads will swear on a stack of timetable that there are only two. Now here the president of New York Central and the president of Haven Hartford railroads, it's a railway station, so president of that railroads, they swear. Swear means when we are just saying something, promising something on the name of God. Okay, so they are swearing on a stake of timetable. Now a stake of timetable, a bundle of timetable is there, and they are swearing on that timetable that yes, there are only two. Now for what they are talking about two? But I say there are three, because I have been on the third level of the Grand Central Station. But I means the protagonist, the writer is saying I was saying there were three, means the president was saying there are only two, I was saying there are three, because I have seen the third level of the Grand Central Station. Yes, I have taken the obvious step. I talked to a psychiatrist friend of mine among others. Now he is clarifying himself that he has talked about this to a psychiatrist friend. Psychiatrist is the people who can read your mindset. The level of your mind means at which level you are going, your mind is going. If you are going through any type of problem, any type of depression, then they can treat you. They can find out the problem, exact problem, and they can treat you. So the hero is called, I told you about the, give you the brief explanation about that. That is, he is talking about his experience to a psychiatrist who was his friend, that at Grand Central Station, according to him, there were three levels, but according to the president of New York Central and president of Haven Grand, New Haven Hartford Railroads, there were only two levels. So I told him about the third level at Grand Central Station, and he said it was a waking dream wish fulfillment. When I told to my psychiatrist friend that at Grand Central Station there are three levels, but all the people are knowing only two levels are there on the station. So when I tell this thing to my psychiatrist friend, he said that I am going to see a waking dream. Waking dream is called daydream, means I am daydreaming. This is my daydream. Wish fulfillment means this is my wish that there should be a third level at this station, and I need to fulfill this wish, and that's why I was seeing a daydreaming, according to my psychiatrist friend. He said I was unhappy. Now my psychiatrist friend prescribed me that I am going through unhappiness. That made my wife kind of mad, but he explained that he meant the modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry, and all the rest of it. After listening that, when my psychiatrist friend said to me that I am going to unhappiness stage, so my wife became very unhappy after listening this. But I am telling you that the modern world in which we are living, that is full of insecurity. Now insecurity is something when you are feeling every time that somebody at some movement you is going to harm you, means there is a type of danger, type of feeling is there. Okay, then fear is there, war is there, worry is there, and all the kind of which things are there that can make your sense unhappiness, all things are there in the modern world, and that I just want to escape. Escape is called I don't want to exist that thing in my life. So I want to get escape from all these things. Well, who doesn't? Everybody I know wants to escape. Now who which is the person? Now tell me a name of a person who wants all these things, all these worried things in their life. Nobody wants. Everybody, whatever I know, they all want to escape from these things, but they don't wander down into any third level at Grand Central Station. But all other people, they are not knowing about there is a third level also at Grand Central Station. Only I know about this. But that's the reason he said, and my friends all agreed. But all of my friends, means I shared this thing with my all friends and they all were agree with this thing. Everything points to it, they claimed. Means whatever claimed is called when you are forcing something to be true. Means they all are saying, yes, this is going to be true. So each and every point, whatever is claimed, that is seems true. My stamp collecting, for example, that's a temporary refuge from reality. Now he is sharing a past incident related to himself, means previous years he is using to collect all the stamps, but that is also very much far away from the reality. Refuge is called when you are coming in the shelter of something, when you are just going away from something to safe side from here. Okay, so refuge from reality means this is not real. Everybody was saying, you are saying there is a third level in the general station, Grand Central Station, but that is not real. Means you are going away from the reality, that is called refuse from reality. Well, maybe, but my grandfather didn't need any refuse from reality. Things were pretty nice. Now he is talking about his grandfather, that yes, my grandfather was also in the habit to collect the stamps, but he is not away from the reality, as my friends are saying I am going away from reality, but my grandfather was not going away from the reality. That was pretty nice thing, means the collecting of the stamps was a pretty nice habit for him and for me. That was very nice and peaceful in his day from all I hear, and he started my collection. Means the collecting stamps habit was very nice, and my grandfather was with me when I started collecting the stamp. It's a nice collection, 2 blocks of 4 practically every US issue, first take covers and so on. Means in my stamp collection, each and every collection, each and every stamps, whatever recently issued by the US government is there. And there was also the first day covers. First day covers is a special name of this stamp that was also there. President Roosevelt collected the stamp too, you know. Means he's just exemplifying, he is just strongly making his point that yes, if I'm going to collect the stamp, means my grandfather was also collecting the stamp, as well as you, if you know, then the president of US Roosevelt, he is also in the habit of collecting the stamp. So it's either very good habit. Anyway, here is what happened at Grand Central. Now again talking about the Grand Central. One night last summer, I worked at night at the office. I was in a hurry to go up town to my apartment, so I decided to take the subway from Grand Central because it's faster than the bus. Now one of the evening, he's talking about one incident when he was coming back from office to go to his home. he's just decided to take a subway. Now, subway is that you are not going to just pass a long way, the usual way, the general way every day you go through. He just decided on that day he's going to pass his way from the other way, that is called a subway, and that is near the Grand Central, because that is faster, means that the way is shorter than the general one. Then now I don't know why this should have happened to me. Now one of the incident, he's not talking, he's not sure about why it's going to be happened with him. I'm just an ordinary guy named Charlie, 31 years old, and I was wearing a tan gabardine suit and a straw hat with a fancy bend. Now he's introducing himself, his name is Charlie, he was 31 and he was wearing a gabardine suit. Now gabardine suit is called the fitted suit, the figure hugging suit he was wearing, and a straw hat with a nice bend on that hat he was wearing. So I passed a dozen of the man who looked just like me. That means there were so many other persons who are just wearing the same dress as I was wearing, and I wasn't trying to escape from anything. I just wanted to get home to Louisa, my wife. Now he is not going to do anything else or anything different from anyone. He was just one of the ordinary person, and he just want to go early to his wife named Louisa. Now I turned into Grand Central from Vanderbilt Avenue and went down the steps to the first level. Now from the place, the name of the place from where he started his journey was Vanderbilt Avenue, and that was of a Grand Central area. Then he started his journey from there, and there were steps, means the stairs were there, and he stepped down, and that was the first level of that station. Where you take trains like the 20th century, the first level is there when where you can find the trains of the 20th century, means the train as we see today's era, now in modern times, like that. Then I walked down another flight to the second level where the sub one trains leave from. Now he moved on towards the second level, and on that level all the trains going to the suburban part. Now suburban is called the nearby part of the city, the outskirt, means the faraway parts which are situated at more distance than the city area. So all the trains related to that area come at the second level, ducked into an arch doorway heading for the subway and got lost. Now ducked into is called, he has to bend himself down because there was an arch doorway. Arch doorway is called, the doorway was in the shape of a round. The round shape was there from the upside of the doorway. So from that doorway he entered inside, moving his head down. But on that subway he got lost, means he was just don't know where he has to go. That's easy to do. I have been in out of the Grand Central hundreds of the time, means hundred of the time before, means like usually every day he comes to this Grand Station, but on that day how he get lost, he was wondering about this. But I'm always bumping into a new doorways and stairs and corridors, means every time whenever he comes to the Grand Station, Grand Central Station, every time he's going to find a new type of doorways and stairs, and so many corridors are there, and he every time he gets shocked about this. Once I got into the tunnel about a mile long, I came out into the lobby of the Roosevelt Hotel. Now one of the incident he was telling about, once he has come to this Grand Central Station, and he found a tunnel. Now tunnel is a type of thing that is covered from all the sides, that has only two gateways, one for entering and one for just passing away, go through. The exit one is there, and all the cover area is there, no open area, means you are going to find a round ceiling in that tunnel, okay, a tube like structure you can say. So he has to pass from that tunnel, and that tunnel comes out to the Roosevelt Hotel, means that at the entry point there was Grand Central Station was there, and when you cross that tunnel the Roosevelt Hotel will come. At the time I came up in an office building on 46th Street, three blocks away. Another time he found another type of tunnel, and he entered that tunnel, and on the exit way he found a building of the 46th Street, it's a address, and that was three blocks away. Means every time he is going to find a new doorway, new corridor and new tunnel, and he was talking about this. Sometime I think Grand Central is growing like a tree pushing out out new corridors and staircases like routes. Now means every time when he comes, he finds every new thing, so many new thing about this station. So he is just comparing the Grand Central Station with the tree. Means as the tree is just spreading its roots in uncertain way, in uncertain direction, the same like Grand Central Station is going to have so many corridors, so many tunnels, so many staircases, and they are just like it roots. Roots is called, they are just spreading at so many direction that one can get confused easily. There is probably a long tunnel that nobody knows about, feeling its way under the city right now. Now he is going to head over a tunnel that is not in the information of each and every person, and that was going under the city right now. Means the city was on the upper land area, and that tunnel was going below of that land area on its way to Times Square. Means it was heading to Times Square. Times Square is the name of a place, and maybe another to Central Park, and maybe because for so many people through the years, Grand Central has been an exit, a way of escape. Now he was just throwing his mind, he was just puzzling his mind. Means this tunnel is can have the exit to maybe to Times Square, maybe to Central Park. But why? Because Grand Central Station was so old that so many people come through this station and find this exit, and this exit can be go in anywhere of a way of escape. Escape is called when you want to go away from something. Maybe that's how the tunnel I got into, but I never told my psychiatrist find about that idea. Means he has just got a new tunnel to go ahead, and he just want to go through that tunnel. That was a new tunnel and going by a very less number of people, but that tunnel must have an exit. So he just find out where is this tunnel going to be finished, and this thing he is not going to share with his psychiatrist friends. The earlier thing means he is going to find a third level on the journal center, the Grand Central Station. He shared this thing with his psychiatrist friend, but this thing means once he has gone through the tunnel at the low level area from the city, this thing he is not going to share with his psychiatrist friend. Now the corridor I was in began angling left and slanting downwards, and I thought that that was wrong. Means now he is describing what type of corridor inside the tunnel is there. Corridor was going towards left, okay, and slanting is called little bent. Means that is slant toward downwards, that was having its slope towards downwards. So he was thinking maybe this way is not right, maybe this way is wrong, but I kept on walking. But a curious type of thing is there, he just want to go on. All I could hear was an empty sound of my own footstep, and I didn't pass a soul. Now a soul means not a other person. He was alone there, he can just hear only his footstep sound, no else person was there. Then I heard that sort of a hollow roar ahead, that means open space and people talking. Now after some time he heard some type of noise. Okay, hollow roar means a type of noise was coming. So he just starting his mind, thinking his mind that yes, I'm going to find some people at and there is going to be an open space after this tunnel, after this corridor, and the people were talking to each other. The tunnel turned a sharp left. Now a sharp left cut has come in that tunnel. I went down a short flight of the stairs and came out on the third level of the Grand Central Station. Now after a sharp left turn, some of the stairs have come. He just get down from the stairs, and here is he was on the third level of the Grand Central Station. For just a moment I thought I was back on the second level, but I saw the room was smaller, there were fewer ticket window and train gates. Now that was looking like as he was on the second level, because that was looking similar to the second level. But after some time he just got out, no, this is not the second level, because whatever the rooms were there, that was smaller in the size, and there were few ticket window was also there. Means you can buy the tickets to go from the train gates, means train gates, train approaches and go from there, departures from there. And the information of the booth in the center was wood and old looking. Now whatever the booth center, the about the railway inquiry center was there, made of wood, and that was looking like very old. And the man in the booth wore a green eye shade and long black sleeve protectors. Now the man who was sitting on that inquiry booth, he was wearing a green shaded glasses, glare sunglasses he was wearing, and he was wearing a black sleeve protectors, black sleeve blazer were there. The light were dim and soft and flickering. Now the light in that booth was a very dim and flickering. Flickering is called moving. Why it was moving? Then I saw why they were open flame gas light, because that was not a electricity, that was an open flame, as we can see the flame in a gas stove like that. So there was an open gas flame, that's why the light was moving here and there. There were brass spittoons on the floor, and across the station a glint of light caught my eye. Now spittoons is something, a type of bin that are made of brass, where that are used to spit into it. Okay, and across the station means at the other side of the station, a glint of light, glint is called a ray of light, was coming, and I attracted towards that light. A man was pulling a gold watch from his waist pocket. Now a man was standing there, he was wearing a waistcoat, and out of that pocket he was taking out a watch. He snapped open to the cover, glanced at his watch and frowned. Now the watch was kept in a cover, he just opened that cover, look at that, glances called look at that, and then frowned. Frowned is gone when you are having the wrinkles on your eyebrows, Mian, means you are showing some anger. Okay, so that man was seeming unhappy, some type of angry man was looking. He wore a derby hat, a black four button suit with tiny lapels. Now he was wearing a derby hat, a type of hat. Then he was wearing a black suit, a four buttons in those suits, and a tiny lapels. Tiny lapels is called the type of tiny simple things that you cover just across your blazer that he was wearing. And he had a big black handlebar mustache. Now he is having a big mustache on his face. Then I looked around and saw that everyone in the station was dressed like 1819 something. Now he is going to see so many peoples after that person, and they all are dressed in 1890s, means the way of years ago dressings were there, they all used to wear. I never saw so many beards, sideburns and fancy mustaches in my life. Now he is seeing the peoples with having so many big beards and sideburns, the woman is used to make a sideburns now in old times like that, and fancy mustache, different type of shapes of mustache with the man, means he has not seen earlier that, because he is in 18 and 19th era, but he was just belonging from the modern era, so they all are belonging from 1819, so this is very new thing for him. A woman walked in through the train gates. She wore a dress with leg of mutton sleeves and skirts to the top of her hair, buttoned shoes. Now he saw a woman who was wearing, he was just coming from the train gate from where the train approaches, and she was wearing a dress whose sleeves was a leg of mutton, means puffy sleeves were there. He was wearing a skirt and a top, and his hair was just going in a buttoned shoes, means a bun was there in her hair. Back of her, out on the tracks, I caught a glimpse of a locomotive. Now when she was coming at the back of her, I can see a glimpse. Glimpse is called a type of like you can see, a glimpse means a look of a locomotive. Locomotive is called a type of train. Okay, this is just because the same name for the train. The train was coming, a very small courier and eaves locomotive with a funnel shaped stack. Now the shape of that means that was a courier train taking something from here and there, and the shape of that is having the funnel shape. Funnel that you have seen, the shape of funnel is there. So the funnel shape locomotive was there, and then I knew yes, okay, this type of train are going to be used in 18 and 19s, because in modern times we can see the metro trains and generally 20th century trains are there, and that are very much different from the trains look that are we having in 18 and 19s. And that Charlie was looking those train and the type of people of 18 and 19 first time in his life. To make sure, I walked over a newsboy and glanced at the stack of papers at his feet. Now, at every other movement, he was finding so many new things, new type of people, new type of atmosphere, a type of train he has never seen. So, just give more confirmation to himself, he approaches to a newsboy. The boy who was handling the carrying a bundle of paper, so he just look at the paper. It was The Word. The name of newspaper was The Word, and The Word hasn't been published for years. He was from 20th century and he has not seen any of the newspaper published by the name of Word for many years. The lead story said something about President Cleveland. Now, whatever the top story was there on the front page was related to the President Cleveland at that time. I have found that front page since in the public library files, and it was printed June 11, 1894. Now, the cutting of the same paper he found in the library, because in the library some of the cuttings, paper cuttings used to be kept of the old papers, magazines. So, Charlie must have seen the cutting of this type of paper in the public library, and that was printed on June 11, 1894. I turned towards the ticket window knowing that here on the third level at Grand Central, I could buy the tickets that would take Louisa and me anywhere in the United States we wanted to go. Now, he just turned himself towards the ticket window because he has to buy a ticket, because that was the third level of Grand Central Station, and he just want to take his wife with him to the different places of the United States. In the year 1894, and I wanted two tickets to Galesburg, Illinois. Now, he just want to take his wife to Galesburg, Illinois in United States of the era 1894. So, he just wanted to buy two tickets. Have you ever been there? It's a wonderful town still with big old frame houses. Now, have you ever been there? He is asking to us. Now, nobody's have seen yet. Means that was a very wonderful and beautiful town that is having the big old frame, big type of houses. Means old type of houses, structures were there. Huge lawns, huge open area was there, and tremendous trees whose branches meet overhead and the roof of the street. Means so big and close, a type of crowd of the trees were there on the street that make a like structure of the canopy. Means you cannot see the sky when you are just looking upward from down of the earth. Means they are so dense trees, so big trees are there that they make a type of canopy. So huge trees were there, also were there. And in 1894, summer's evening were twice as long, and people sat out in their lawns, the man smoking cigars and talking quietly. Means they are, now he is going to just creating a type of atmosphere that used to be in 80s and 90s world. Means during the evening time, we are having so much work in the modern time, but at that time, they are having rather more bigger evening because nobody is having so much work as we are just making ourselves, as just we are throwing ourselves to do the hard work. At that time, people are just relaxing in the lawn. The men are going to be enjoying the cigars and talking to each other quietly. The women waving palm leaf fans. Now, women were having a fans, palm leaf made of the palm leaves. The fans were there, hand fans that they were just waving is called moving here and there with the fireflies all around. Means they were feeling some type of hot. So for that, they are carrying fans of made of palm leaves in their hand. Fireflies were there all around, the type of insect that used to be in the air. Those were there in a peaceful world. And everywhere there is a type of peace, a kind of peace was spreading there. To be back there with the first world war is still 20 years off, and world war second over 40 years in the future. I wanted two tickets for that. Means he is talking about of that era, from which era is still the First World War is going to be happen after 20 years in the future, and Second World War is going to be happen after 40 years of the in the future. So he is talking about that era. So he just want to go in that era with his wife Louisa, and for that he just wanted to buy two tickets, fine. Now the clerk figured the fare, he glanced at my fancy hat band, but he figured the fare, and I had enough for two coach tickets one way. Now clerk was taking, telling me about the fare, figured is called, just he was telling how much fare he needed for buying two tickets, okay. So he glanced at my glanced is called see, he just saw at my fancy hat band, there was a ribbon band around my hat, so he was looking on that band, but he figured the fare, and I had enough for two tickets. He is having enough money to buy two tickets, but when I counted out of the money and looked up, the clerk was staring at me. But when he started giving the money to the clerk again is going to staring at him. Staring is called looking at once, looking continuously, as I have done something like that. He nodded at the bills, that that aren't money, mister, he said, and if you are trying to skin me, you won't get very far. Now clerk has nodded this call, so just to move the head on the bills, and he was saying, this is not money, mister, means I'm not going to accept this money. If you're trying to skin me, skin is called ditch me or deceive me, or cheat. If you are just trying to cheat me, you are not going very far. Very far means you are not going very far from the clutch of the police, means I'm going to give you in the police because you are cheating me. And he glanced at the cash drawer beside him, then he again look at his cash drawer that was beside him. Of course the money was old style bills, half again as big as the money we use nowadays, and different looking. Now he also take a look on the money that he is having in the cash drawer, that was a type of old type of money. The currencies there means the money, the rupees we are using today in the modern times, the old times money was rather bigger or different looking from the money that right now we are using. I turned away and got out fast. There is nothing nice about jail even in 1894. Now Charlie said nothing because he is not owning the currency that used to be in the vogue or that used to be used in that era. He is having the money of modern era. So when he just heard about the cheated word and going in the jail, he just turned and come out fast. And because jail is same in each and every era, means if you are going in jail, the jail will be same in 18 or 19th or in the 20th century. And that was that. I left the same way I came, I suppose. Now the same way he just left out, he just come out from the Grand Central's third label from where he has gone out. Next day during lunch hour, I drew $300 out of the bank, nearly all we had, and bought old style currency that really worried my psychiatrist friend. Now he has to buy the tickets to go in 18th and 19th century, so for that he has to take out, he had to just arrange the money that is going to be used in that era. So he has just taken out the $300. But about this, if my psychiatrist friend is not is going to be know about this thing, that he is not going to be very happy with me. He is going literally is going to be worried about this thing. You can buy old money at most any coin dealers, but you have to pay a premium. Now from where you can find the old style money, means a type of different currency, you can buy from any coin dealer, means the dealer, a type of dealer are there who are having different type of currency, okay. So you can buy from there, but you have to give some premium. Premium is called means some extra money you have to give. My $300 bought less than 200 in old style bills, but I did not care. For 13 cents at dozen in 1894. Now when I gave him $300, the person, the coin the coin dealer gave me 200 of the old style, means I have to pay $100 extra for that. But it's okay, that was okay for Charlie. Why? Because in 1894 one dozen ad came of rupees 13 cents, means that was quite well, okay, means that was not very much expensive. So he was just feeling fine after getting 200 after getting 200 rupees of old time by paying $300 of modern times. But I have never again found the corridor that leads to the third level at Grand Central Station, although I have tried often enough. Now again, after getting the old type of currency, he came to Grand Central Station and started going on that way, but he was unable to find the same way he came last time. Means he was, after thorough searching, he was not able to find out the third level tunnel of the Central Station. Now Loisa was pretty worried when I told her all this. My wife happens to be very worried about this when I told her all about this, and didn't want me to look for the third level anymore, and after a while I stopped. Now she was with me, so she was getting worried, and after some time she told me, please stop searching third level, and then I too stopped. I went back to my stamps. Now just I have left my mind about searching the third level, and I just again concentrate my mind about collecting the stamps. But now we were both looking every weekends, because now we have proof that the third level is still there. But after sharing this thing to Loisa, my wife was also going to be believe on this thing a little bit, because I have a proof with me. I have so many incident, so many proof were there, like I am going to buy the old currency notes. Why? Because I have seen through my eyes. So I am just with my wife going to be on Grand Central Station literally near about every weekend and try to search the third level. My friend Sam Weiner disappeared. Nobody knew where. Now the Sam Weiner was a friend of Charlie, and suddenly he disappeared. Means he vanished. Nobody is going to know where he has gone. But I sort of suspected, because Sam's a city boy, and I used to tell him about Galesburg. I went to school there. Means a type of suspected, because Sam was a city boy. I used to be suspect is called, means I am not believing on something, because Sam was a city boy. Sam was a boy who used to be live in city, and I used to tell him about the Galesburg, the old town where Charlie got his education, and he always said he liked the sound of the place, and that's where he is all right in 1894. Means all the time Sam, his friend, also tell him that yes, I just want to go at that place also in 1894, the old town, because I like the sound of that place, the different job of that place. So he was just supposing that Sam Weiner must have gone in the era of 1894. Because one night, fussing with my stamp collection, I found, well, fussing is called busy. So one night Charlie was very much busy with his stamp collection, and he found something. Do you know what a first day cover is? When a new stamp is issued, stamp collectors buy some of them. Means the first day cover. Now the name has come before in the chapter, I told you, and that is related to the stamp. So first day cover is related with the stamp. Whatever the new stamp is issued by the government, that is kept in the collection of Charlie's also, and that is going to be issued by the government. That means the very first stamp, the issued stamp, is going to be called the first day cover. Stamp collector buys and use them to mail envelopes to themselves on the very first day of the sale. Means the first day cover is called the stamp that is issued, and very first day they are going to be sold, because whenever we are going to send any letters to anyone, on the envelope we are supposed to put a stamp on that, and the postmark proves the date. And the first day cover, there was a date, that is a type of postmark that is proving the date of that stamp. The envelope is called the first day cover. Now whatever the envelope is going on the first day sale with the newly stamped is there, that is called first day cover. So that envelope with the stamp is called first day cover. Now they are never opened. You just put blank paper in the envelope. Now he's supposing he is just going to find out a first day cover. Means he found a paper, an envelope from his stamp collection, but he was supposing there was nothing rather than a blank paper. That night, among my oldest first takeovers, I found one that shouldn't have been there. But when I was searching my stamp collection, then I found the oldest first day covers. Means he just found an envelope in that was not supposing by Charlie. Means Charlie was not thinking about that he can find, but he found one. But there it was. It was there because someone had mailed it to my grandfather at his home in Galesburg. Means there was the envelope that is sent by the other person to his grandfather. Means that envelope was related with his grandfather, and that envelope has come from Galesburg. That's what the address on the envelope said. Means the address was written, the sender's address was written on the envelope, and that was came from Galesburg. And it had happened that since July 1894, the postmark showed that. Yet I didn't remember it at all. Means the date was also written on that. That was the date of July 1894, because the date was written. So that was considered as postmark. But he was not remember anything about this envelope. The stamp was at 6 cent dull brown with a picture of President Garfield. Now there is a stamp put on that envelope, and that was worth rupees 6 cent, and that became a dull brown, means the vanished brown, not very cool brown. That was a dull brown color stamp was there, and on that stamp the picture of President Garfield was depicted. Naturally, when the envelope came to Granddad in the mail, it went right into his collection and stayed there till I took it out and opened it. Obviously someone has sent this first grand letter, the first day cover, means the envelope with the first issued stamp of the president that was there. So that obviously that was going to the collection of the stamp of my grandfather. But right now I am opening this envelope. The paper inside wasn't blank, it read. Means he was supposing maybe there was nothing written on the paper, but there was written something on the paper. Now it reads, Charlie is going to read the letter. You can see the picture of letter, that is Captain Envelope. 941 Wilson Street, Galesburg, Illinois, July 1894. Charlie. So the letter is addressed to Charlie. I got to wishing that you were right, then I got to believing you were right. And Charlie, it's true. I found the third label. I have been here 2 weeks, and right now down the street at the Diffie, someone is playing a piano, and there are all out on the front porch singing Seeing Nelly Home, and I am invited over for lemonade. Come on, Black Charlie and Louisa, keep looking till you find the third label. It's worth it, believe me. Now something very wondered thing is written in this letter. Means only Charlie was there who was believing on the third label of the Grand Central Station. But about that third label, this letter is also talking about. Means whoever has written in this letter, he was also in the consent, he was also agreed that yes, there was a third label in the Grand Central Station, and that person stayed there for 2 weeks, and then after that he was just writing about what is going to be happening. Means someone is going to play the piano, and his grandfather was invited by him on lemonade is just called the lemon juice is there. Okay, means on the occasion of just having some refreshment, and everybody who was sitting near the piano, they were all singing the song Seeing Nelly Home, and he was just going back to Charlie and Louisa, and they were just telling him, Charlie and Louisa, just keep believing in you, believe in me, and looking off whatever the label you are going to find, that is right. The note is signed Sam. Now there was a signature on the note, and who signed it? Sam signed it. At the stamp and coin store I go to, I found out that Sam brought $800 worth of the old style currency. Now he has brought the old currency out of in the exchange of $300. Now after this, Charlie came to know that his friend Sam, who was a psychiatrist, he also came to buy the old currency tickets out of the $800 that ought to set him up in the nice little hay. Means hay is called the dry grass. Okay, means in that area, in that era, 18 and 90s, we are going to just to feel this type of atmosphere that used to be in the small town and villages. So feed and grain business means Sam is going to be like to do the feed and grain business that is used to be by the town peoples. He always said that's what he really wishes he could do, and he certainly can't go back to his old business. Means he just want to do just go in this business of grain business and feed business, and he just doesn't want to come back to his old business. Not in Galesburg, Illinois, in 1894, his old business. Why Sam was my psychiatrist means he just want to go in the Illinois in 1894, and he just want to go in the old business, and that was my friend Sam, psychiatrist. Okay, means once Charlie was just feeling so much hesitation to tell all the things related to the third level to his friend Sam, because nobody was believing, because third level was just an imagination. And yes, the conclusion of this chapter is that third level of Grand Center Station is not a place. That place not exist. There is no such place. That is all imagination of the mind of Charlie. And yes, about the Sam, whatever the he is writing about the Sam, that is also a type of imagination about his friend. So I hope you just caught this explanation. It is just a little bit confusing. When you get the explanation again, then you are going to just go through and very much understood about the chapter. Just try to summarize the chapter yourself. When we are going to complete the question, answer and exercise part, then you are going to understand more and in a better way. So that's it for now. We'll meet again.